My name is Michel Ridder. I'm from Amsterdam, the Netherlands. I'm a visual artist working mainly with photography and video. I'm here at NARS for a period of 3 months, supported with a stipend of the Stockroos Foundation. I'm working on a project where I try to visualize the atmosphere. So I want to do something with the distance and with the light and processes, what happens in the far distance. So I try to photograph that and film that. And I'm also working with colors, but in the end, also I found how to work I'm making is also a little bit about the summer, about heat and stuff like that. Yeah. But the main subject is really the wandering. You know, like you are in this crazy place. You are in life. And then, you quickly realize, or I realize, you can't really grasp it, you can't really understand it. But what you can do is, look, you know, and look better. And the more you look, the more you see. And then through art, you can also, learn stuff about reality. And what you learn is not the truth or something, or how, you know, life is, or the world is, but you discover like hidden aspects, and you can experience that, and this experience, and it's most also experience of course of beauty, or not, that can you enrich yourself and also lift you from your daily life. You know, I think it's good that from time to time you get like picked up and you're lifted and to a higher level, of selfness. What is special about NARS is this, I think, this communal thing. Of course, NARS is set in this like fairy tale environment, which I think is sometimes almost too fairy tale. I sometimes miss the rough sides of reality here. But also this, because it's so crazy fairy tale, it's also interesting to experience this. And of course, working with like 10 people, so it feels also like a monastery sometimes. I'm very surprised also by the social interaction, which is also nice. You know, it pulls you also a little bit out of yourself, which is also really good. And I think the setup is really special. You know, with the communal dinners, I think that this is, if you were with like 10 people in this setting, I think it's very important that you have like once a day, like an official meeting moment. Otherwise, I think people would like, it would be more like a hotel, you know, people would like see each other in a rush. And this makes it also special. Maybe it's also part of the experience as a whole. Yeah, the biggest challenge. Now, one of the challenges is also because it's also a little bit closed. It isn't what is difficult, I think, challenging. It is an institution, and somehow it is also constraining. And I feel that the organization itself, they try to be very, really open. They try to give a lot of room for, you know, expression to be not, but still they're there. You know, there is still this feeling of constraint, and it is and also the building itself, like if you see, it's like walls like 1 meter thick, and I'm now starting to camp also a little bit, and I think also that is good to really sometimes really be out of it, to be more into connection with the landscape. It's somehow I sometimes yeah now it's raining, it's very nice here inside, but sometimes I think it's too much inside, you know, and the inside is also really framed, like organized in a certain way, and that I think that's a challenge for me to how to relate to this, you know, that yeah. What do I like the most? Yeah, I like the smell outside the most, actually. But that's because I'm from Amsterdam and we have very bad air. The air is very polluted, especially in summer. And yeah, when I drive here from Amsterdam, I come in, the first thing I noticed was this crazy smell, you know? Everything is sweet and fresh and yeah, that's also why I walk to the wood station nearby, because you know this wood, it smells so fantastic, you know. And I also have the feeling now where I'm longer here, that I smell really more stuff. Like the longer I'm here, the more I smell. So I think that's the best thing for me. It's like this, and it's also special because I know it's really this place also. If you also travel up the mountains, you have all these flowers and these meadows and. It's all the yesterday was also up with the Bergbahn, and then I was surprised there's so much flowers up there. You could, and then if the sun starts to shine on the fields, then you can really notice it when the sun comes, and then whew, you can also like have this whim of smell. And so that's, yeah, I think that's the nicest part here. Yeah.